requires integration by parts. All right, so our evil plan. Which, if you recall, is the integral of u dv is equal to, do you remember? Good, it's u times v minus the integral of v du. Now, I hope you'll forgive any tapping sounds. I just got this iPad Pro and I do not have my Bluetooth headphone near me, so you may hear tappity tappity tap. I shall remedy that soon. Okay, so we need to use integration by parts. That is the formula. And what you want to do is you want to do find the indefinite integral first. Definite integral first. Since there's more than one term. Now, I don't know if you remember, but when you have an exponential like this, times a trigonometric function, so if you have sine of x or cosine of x or some linear function of times e to the x, where they're both linear functions, meaning it's not x squared or root x or, you know, x to some other power other than one. You can have a coefficient, but not powers on the x that are different. The way we do this is we perform integration by parts twice, and we equate like integrals. So here we go. We are going to go ahead and write the indefinite integral here, e to the x times sine at x dx, right, equals. Now, we're going to be using integration by parts twice, so we may want to use subscript, meaning instead of just u equals and dv equals, we may want to say u1 equals and dv1 equals. So here we go. I shall do that. U1 is going to equal to sine at x. And then differentiating, still getting used to the controls here, differentiating both sides with respect to x, we shall have I'm getting confused on the reds, my bad. We shall have du1 cosine of x dx. And all I did here was du1 dx was equal to cosine of x, and I multiplied both sides by dx. Okay? So the rest of the factors in the integral will be what our dv is equal to. So we have our, sorry, lost some of my g here. So we'll have our dv1 is equal to, beautiful, e to the x dx, and then integrating both sides, integrate, integrate, we have v1 is just equal to e to the x. Moving along, we will have, I'm going to leave a little space, the integral of e to the x times sine at x dx equals. So our u1 was equal to sine at x, v1 was e to the x minus the integral of v1, which again is e to the x, and we now have our du1 that we need, which was good. Cosine of x dx. Alrighty, so I'll highlight this stuff so you can see which goes, you know, which thing goes with what. So starting with this guy here, that was our du1. And then going to our initial u sub, we had u1 was equal to sine at x. So that is our u1. So that's kind of the deal here. And remember the du part is here. Now we got to figure out our dv. So we have all these different colors. That's nice. Let's do our dv1 was equal to e to the x dx, right? And then finally our v is, or v1 rather, is e to the x. Cool so far? Awesome. So, here we go. Continuing to rewrite both. So we have our e to the x times sine at x dx is equal to, I'm just going to write it prettier, e to the x times sine at x minus, I'll write this where it looks more normal, e to the x times cosine at x dx. So now notice that we need to do this again. So here we go. If we have our u2 is now equal to what? Beautiful, cosine at x. And sorry. Differentiating both sides with respect to x and doing a little bit of algebra, we will end up getting du2 is equal to negative sine at x dx. All right, now we need to find dv1, dv2. So we'll have dv2 is equal to, beautiful, e to the x dx. And then integrating both sides, we will have v2 is equal to e to the x. All right, so now, remember, this was all part of the evil plan. The first step was no one use that formula. Then we need to find this indefinite integral, right? And so, just keep our work here separate, getting closer. So now when we do these substitutions, we will have e to the x times sine at x dx equals e to the x times sine at x minus, now we're doing the integration by parts on the second one. So we have our next one, which would be u2 times v2. So we'll have, what was our u2? Our u2 was cosine at x. Our v2 is e to the x minus the integral of, good, v2, which is e to the x, times du2, which is negative sine at x dx. Cool so far? Let's do our du in a darker purple. du2. So we had done, yeah. So du2 is this darker purple, and that is here. Cool. And so that's the, you know, second part of the integration by parts. And then with our, I'll do a darker blue. I'll do the same kind of thing for our u's. So our darker blue is like that. And so in this case, we were substituting for this one. And we have U2 is over here. And we're good there. What else do we need? We also need our DV2 was in kind of a light pink color. Ooh, yikes. I guess I'll do a more red. Hopefully it won't look too crazy. DV2 is this e to the x dx. And then V2 gives us, I'll do a lighter green, I guess, for V2. And so V's, V2, and V2. Cool. Now, I'm noticing that I forgot to do the initial V's on there. Awesome. All right, so now let's put it all together. I know these problems can be a bit on the long side, but hang in there. So rewriting it to make it prettier, we'll have e to the x times sine at x dx equals e to the x times sine at x minus e to the x times cosine at x. So I'm distributing the minus through. So this one becomes negative, but do you notice this one is going to be minus a minus a minus from the negative inside the integral? So it'll stay minus. And then we have our integral of e to the x times sine at x dx. Now, notice that really you could think of these as having coefficients of 1, right? So if I literally add 1 integral e to the x times sine of x dx to both sides of this equation, I'll end up with two of these bad boys on the left and then on the right side I'll have e to the x. Now I'm going to factor out an e to the x, so we'll be left with, so notice that those zero out and we'll be left with e to the x times quantity sine of x minus cosine of x. And then, dividing by 2, I'll have e to the x times sine of x dx is equal to e to the x over 2 times sine of x minus cosine of x. Cool so far? Awesome. So, now, we need to evaluate these limits of integration. So let's come back here, all right? We've completed most of the evil plan, all right? But now we need to, so let's put steps. So the first step is really knowing that we needed to use integration by parts. Second step was finding the indefinite integral first. Now our third step is going to be evaluate the limits of integration. And it's always good to be very neat here. You never want to, it's kind of crazy. Here we are. So evaluate the limits of integration. So we want to annotate again, and we want the pen. Integration. And let's see, I don't need this to be so long. Let's go back here. All right. So here, notice that you're probably thinking to yourself, why isn't she saying plus C, right? Well, I could definitely be putting a plus C here for the indefinite, but the C, that constant of integration, will zero out when we evaluate the antiderivative at the limits of integration. So let's be neat about this. Let us come down here. I'll use a different color. We, at the end of the day, we wanted to know what is the integral from 0 to 5 of e to the x times sine at x times dx. And we found out that the antiderivative was e to the x over 2 times sine at x minus cosine at x, leaving out the plus c, and we're going from x is 0 to x is 5. So we will have this equal to, the 1/2 is a constant, all right? So our upper limit of integration will be e to the 5th times sine at 5 minus cosine at 5. I know it looks a little strange. And then minus lower limit of integration, which will be, and that would be 2 parens, which would be e to the 0 times sine at 0 minus cosine at 0. Okay. So we will have 1/2 times, the first one will stay the same, right? E to the 5th times sine at 5 minus cosine at 5. And then e to the 0 is 1, right? So we'll get minus 1 times 0 minus 1. That'll turn that 1 to positive. So then we will have 1/2 times e to the 5th times sine at 5 minus cosine at 5 plus 1. And then on the calculator, then you would just get your approximation on the calculator. I'm sure they asked for that. So that would be approximately. Sorry, I don't have my graphing calculator app yet for the for this one, but I end up getting, when I calculate it out, I end up getting 91.70. So this is the exact result, and this is the approximate or rounded result. Cool beans. All right, you guys have a great day. Bye.